All right, in this video, we're going to be making this pushpit for the back of Breezy, which is a 1969 sailboat. 25mm OD stainless steel pipe. So one trick you can do with tape measure is the end always moves a lot. So what you can do is just go off the 100 and makes it much more accurate. So 78.5, it's around there. That's a trick. All right, now that this is all marked out, the next step is to plug the ends of the pipe with sand, because if you bend it without sand, it will crinkle. The sand I'm using is from a sandblaster. It's actually called garnet. Garnet is super fine, and it shouldn't compress much as well. You can use pretty much any sand as long as there's not much like air left when you compress it in. So the first thing you want to do is you want to plug the end of one side and make sure it's really nice and tight. The way I'm going to do it is use a bolt. It's just going to go in like that. And gaffer tape. Around. Like so. Doesn't have to be pretty. I'm not an expert on this, but you know. I think it's rocket science. So it looks like that. And that can't move. Get a funnel, get the sand, pour the sand into the funnel. Sand has reached the top. You want to compress it. So there's the sand. I'm just going to bang it. Doesn't want to go in, but watch this. So you can see it's going in a lot more. Yep. This whole thing now is full of sand and it's compacted. So when you go to bend it, what will happen is the sand will keep things pressurized so it doesn't crumple. So this is what it looks like. Seal that in, and then now I'm gonna take the rest of it off. So this is the one that's gonna go to 90 degrees. All you do is put it in the pipe bender. I just like to use a bit of lube. So this is the setup. You got the die there. Bit of rubber just to try and even the load out because it's not perfect. Let's see what happens. So the thing about this is you go past a 90 degree bend because there's something called spring back. So the thing will actually spring back. I actually got to use my iPhone to measure the angles now. So this is what came out of the vise or the press. You can see there's a bit of an indent here, which isn't pretty, but I think I'll be able to weld that back up to fill it in and grind it back. These aren't perfect. These aren't really good for like these bends. You need a mandrel bender. That's how you do it properly, but this is what we have, so yeah. If you did what I did, which is overbend it, you can just chuck it, suck some clamps in, and you can just pull on that, and you'll be able to bend like slight bends. So this is just slightly out. See that? This one needs to be, so the one that I just bent needs to be pulled a little bit more. Pulled this one out, and with this one I used both the rubber and this cardboard EA, and look there's not even a crease, whereas like these old ones had creases. Oh, considering redoing the whole thing with that, nah. There you go, it's bent. I think it's a bit of an improvement over this one because there's no creases there, not much. What's interesting is that notch there is quite big compared to the first iteration, so obviously the cardboard seems to do better than the rubber. But yeah, I'm pretty happy with that. So now I'm gonna weld on the bases. And yeah, cut everything to size, right height. I think these are too tall right now, so I'm gonna take a little bit off. But yeah, so I'm pretty happy with this bender. Never used it before for this application. So yeah, clean that up, nice. So I'm gonna cut off about 70 mil off here and here. This is how I'm gonna do it. We got the cold cut saw over here. It's all set up, ready to go. All it does is it's got some oil. Makes such good cuts, seriously. All right, so I just fab these little things up, these little pads, these mounts. These mounts are gonna be what the thing, you know, the push pit.
it's gonna bolt into. I need to angle this like by like 10 degrees because that will make it look a little bit more aesthetic. So I gotta work out how to do that. Just don't know if I don't angle it whether I have enough weld to fill, but anyways, we'll work out.
Yeah, really good, man.
All right, this is the return to this project. We have now welded on the bases to the frame, which is bent. This is one side, not the best welding in the world, but she'll do. And this is the other side, huge gaps. I don't have the patience to notch it properly. And a friend said, he's a boilermaker, he said if you can walk across it, you can weld across it. Anyways, these are the rails on now. Just the drive in. They're pretty strong though.